Welcome back to my channel for another bullet journal plan with me video. Today we are planning for the month of May. It's kind of crazy that it's already May. April was really busy for me and May is going to be somewhat busy as well, especially the first couple weeks. So I decided to do a simpler theme for May. Again, I know April's was also pretty simple, but I think a lot of times a simpler theme can be easier to help us actually use our bullet journals or our planners and stay on track and be more productive instead of worrying too much about the doodles. So I thought a simple and easy spread or theme would be good for this month as well. My color theme for this month is inspired by the rose card you can see in the top right. That is actually just a little piece of promotional material that came with a bouquet of flowers, but I thought the drawings were pretty, so I decided I would cut them out and use them in one of my themes. Using random scraps of paper like that is a great way to come up with themes for your bullet journal spreads if you're not really feeling inspired or feeling like you want to use a certain color. I would definitely recommend using flyers or other random scraps of paper you might have laying around as inspiration. It can be a great way to come up with a theme that you wouldn't normally. After I cut out these roses, I used a glue dot tape dispenser to glue them in on different pages, as well as adding a couple washi tapes. This black and gold one is from Walmart, and the white one that has little gold butterflies on it is from Amazon. These are also different glue tape dispensers than I normally use. This one is from Amazon, and you can get a 4-pack for, I believe, $12. I usually get mine from Tombow, but I needed to use a lot of them this last month and I didn't really want to spend the Tombow price on them. These ones have worked really well for me so far, so I would definitely order them again. I couldn't decide which flower I wanted where, so I cut out a couple and placed them around to see where they would look best. Then I decided to just write in the calendar first instead of taping in flowers and then go from there. Like I mentioned last month, I like to have this little typical calendar view over in the corners so that way I can see what day of the week each day is. Also, for all of the black, I have been using a Tombow Mono drawing pen in size 02. All of the headers on this calendar are basically the exact same as last month. There are my trackers, events, tasks, socials, and notes sections. This theme worked really well for me last month, so I decided to have the same monthly spread because it was very easy to use, especially if I had a lot of things going on. After adding a flower and some washi tape along the bottom, I checked where my monthly tab would need to be and then added a washi tape about in the middle of the page. This is just so I can easily find the beginning of each month as I'm flipping through my bullet journal. This page is my tracker page, and it's going to be different from pretty much anything I've ever done. I'm adding in an old tracker that I didn't use last month, and I'm changing up the format a little. Normally these are horizontal, but I decided to make them vertical this time. And basically it's just numbered 1 to 31 from top to bottom, and then across the top are different number sections for different things I track. The left side is 1 through 10, and like usual it's for my physical, sleep, stress, and mood. The right hand side of the spread is going to be a page for me to write down good things that happened during the month or things that made me smile, so I am just decorating it with a flower and a couple pieces of washi tape, and then writing across the top good things are happening using a Tombow hard tip Futanosuke marker, and then I'm going to use a Tombow brush pen to just draw a red line across the lettering. I ended up not loving the way that May looked, so I added in some more shading and highlighted notes with red to draw in some more of that color, and then added a bit more black over May to give it some more texture and depth. Finally, I am creating the first weekly spread for May, just going to make simple boxes for each day, and each of these boxes is using one of the three different markers that I had used, so they're all slightly different colors. It's a little harder to see on camera, but there are two reds and one slightly purple red. I used a Tombow Mono drawing pen to write the day and day of the week above the boxes, and also the time for the craft fair on Saturday, since I already know the specific time for that. And then I just added some decorations with flowers and washi tape. And that is pretty much all for this month. It wasn't meant to be a minimal theme, but it ended up being pretty simple because I needed something I could set up quickly and without too much hassle. I hope you enjoyed this theme. Thank you again for watching, and if you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. See you guys next month.